time to mend your broken heart.
Why do you look so pale? Oh no, your skin has been so hot since last night.
So do you think that not coming home is nothing? I don't know what's in San Isidro that makes him stay there.
Julian!
What happened?
Julian!
His temperature earlier was 39.8.
Julian, you should have told me. I'm not just your coach. You can consider me as a brother, too.
You got a low score in your pop quiz. Julian, your midterm grades might be affected if you don't submit a makeup project for it.
All your football training with Julian, it's not helping him, so please stop it.
Badong, Arsene, Roger, I think it's better if we sell the ducks already.
What? Huh?
Can you please give this to Phil?
Of course, no problem.
Please make sure that he eats that. He likes that.
Oh, by the way, Peter, thanks for the carton. We'll put holes in this so we can put the ducks inside.
Ducks?
Yes.
Yes.
You see, we have a delivery later for 25 ducks.
No, it's okay.
Okay.
I'm full.
He refused the porridge?
Mrs. Miranda, I still have 25 ducks for you.
It looks like Mrs. Miranda is going to buy all of Phil's ducks.
He really looks sad. Maybe you could talk to Phil about this. Maybe there's something you could say to make him feel better.
You are like family to us. You dream more. Be a better man.
I guess you're right. When you said that I should move forward so I can be a better man. And when the time is right, everything will fall into place.
Okay, to be fair, let's put this to a vote. Who is in favor of making Julian stop playing football?
It's a tie. Why don't we ask Grandma?
Oh, that's right, Mom.
Julian should continue playing football.
It's settled. The votes have been cast.
Go ahead. You can go on with your training.
Pino, thank you.
These ducks, I'm sure they'll be a really big help for all of you to have extra income, right? So I won't sell them anymore. I will give the ducks to you. They're yours.
Ma'am Trining, here are your eggs.
Okay.
Okay.
Here's the payment.
Next time, if you need some more eggs, just ask Badong, Arsing, or Roger, because I just gave my ducks to them, okay?
Okay, thank you.
You're welcome.
All right, please place them here.
Hey, nurse!
Hi, Phil!
Were you jogging? Let me join you next time.
Huh? Are you not contented with your football activity with Gab and Julian? You play football with them, yet you still want to jog with me. Really, Phil, you can only do one thing at a time, not two. Come on.
But I can manage. I can do it.
Huh? That's a problem. You think that just because you're handsome and smart and muscular, you can do everything you want? But you can't, Phil. You cannot do two.
Nurse, I'm telling you I can.
And here I thought you were different. I thought it was going to be you. You made us think there was everlasting love, only to realize there isn't. We were wrong.
Hey, are you okay? I mean, what's wrong? Do you have a problem with me?
Do you like Gab?
Yes, of course. I mean, as a friend, she's very friendly, warm. I like her as a friend, like you and Miggy.
Then how come you didn't give us love letters? Why only Gab?
What?
Geez, stop pretending you don't know. Really, why did you give Gab a love letter, huh?
Love letter?
Huh? Pinang saw you. You gave Gab a love letter. And Gab's eyes, like, really lit up. Like she saw stars in the sky after reading it.
That one. Yes, that's a love letter, but that's for Pinang. I just asked Gab to translate it in Filipino.
All right, whatever you say.
Hey, you don't believe me? Here, nurse. Here, look.
Dear Pina, una pa lang kitang makita, may naramdaman na akong kakaiba na hindi maipaliwanag. Oh, dear.
See?
Oh my gosh, this is so embarrassing. We were too quick to judge you. Well, that was because Pinang got jealous at once.
Jealous?
She was like jealous when you gave Gab a love letter.
Pinang is jealous? Hey, Nars, I'm going to the farm. To the farm, okay? To Pinang.
Huh?
I just have something to explain to her, okay? Thanks.
Mm-hmm. Don't you have somewhere else to go to first?
No.
You
okay,
may have.
Take care.
Oh, Pinang is going to get mad at me for sure.
Hello?
Hello, Pinang. Are you busy today?
Well, I'm just folding our newly washed clothes. Why?
She sounds normal. Looks like Phil hasn't arrived yet.
Tell her to come here to meet us. Make her leave the house right now, please.
Pinang, come here. Meet us here in town. Hurry.
But I still have a lot to do here at home.
Please, come on.
Well, it's because...
Hold on. Is there a problem? To be afraid of something. I don't understand.
Me? Afraid? Excuse me, it's not me. Maybe Nora's here, scared you might get mad.
Hmm? Why will I get mad?
Well, it's because... We'll explain later. Just leave the house now before Phil gets there.
Phil? Why would I do that? Oh, there he is.
I can see him now.
Oh, Leah, hide!
Quick, get away from there!
I should hide? But why should I hide?
It's because...
Why am I the one explaining to you, Nars? You two be explaining. It's your fault.
You know, I kind of told Phil you got jealous over a Gab. I'm so sorry, okay? Bye, love you.
What?
You are so dead.
Hello? Hey!
Pinang? Pinang! 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 Hello? Pinang! Pinang! Hello? Pinang! Pinang! Pinang? Pinang!
What am I doing here? There's nowhere I can hide. Oh, you're going to get it, Nars. Where can I hide? Right here? Maybe he won't see me.
Pinang!
I'm not here. I'm not here, Phil. I'm not here.
Pinang! Hey! There you are.
Phil!
What are you doing here?
Nothing. I'm just checking this out. I tried lying down on it. It's nice and soft.
Really?
What are you doing here?
Pinang, we need to talk.
Huh?
I was wondering why you're so distant these past few days.
Distant? Me? Of course not. I'm here most of the time.
I thought it was because of Julian's grade being low or the football training. I kept wondering if I did something wrong, but I couldn't imagine anything else until Nars came a while ago and he...
Hey! I know about that. Whatever he told you, it's not true. Don't believe him. Come on, it's Nars.
So, you're not jealous?
Jealous? Me? Of course not. Why should I get jealous when there's nothing between us? I have no right.
Of course you do. You have my heart.
Excuse me, Phil.
Hey, Pinang. The letter, it was not for Gab. I just asked her a favor just to translate in your language. Here. Maybe you can I can read it for you, if you want.
Phil, no. Remember, I gave my word to my parents that we are just friends? So please don't do this. Don't court me.
And I also gave you my word that I'll stop courting you. But I never said that I will stop loving you. Pinang, you okay? Are you mad? Please, say something.
I feel itchy.
Itchy?
There are lots of ants. Ouch!
Oh no!
Ouch!
Wait, let me help you. Pinang. Let me help you.
Thank you. It's really itchy.
Are you okay?
Yes. Ant bites are really so itchy. I'll just, put vinegar. Wait, stop it. I'll look for vinegar,
vinegar
first.
Vinegar?
Yes, it will help ease the itch of the insect bite. Excuse
okay.
me. Where is it?
Good day, Mr. Emil. I'm here by the water pump because Pinang was in a hurry. She was in a hurry because of, itchy, there were ants, and she got bitten, and, look at her feet.
There were ants?
Yes, her feet. They bit her feet,
Dad. Hello.
Pinang.
Yes?
Are you the one who smells like vinegar?
Mm-hmm.
Huh. Are you really that busy to forget about taking a bath?
Oh, come on, Dad. I just had to put vinegar on my legs and feet because I got bitten by ants.
Where in the world did you go that you got bitten by ants?
Well, in the farm by the haystacks.
And what were you doing there?
Nothing, just enjoying the fresh air. You want some coffee? I can prepare some good coffee for you.
Sir Emil, I'll get going.
Okay, Phil.
Pinang, take care of your feet.
Please sit down. I'll make your coffee. Sorry, my hands smell. Just take a seat. Just get a cup, Dad. Here it is.
Hey, Julian. How are you? It's good to see you back.
I'm okay now. I'm better. And I need to catch up with our lessons.
Really? You might be forcing yourself to come to class.
Of course not. As a matter of fact, I could play football again.
Football? You might suffer a relapse and collapse again.
Yes. Are you really okay, Julian?
Are you sure you're okay?
Hey, why are you smiling?
Margaret, he's just feeling giddy.
Because you're concerned about him.
Of course not.
All right, the two of you, knock it off. Just remember, Julian, don't play football for now. Do you know your sister was worried about you yesterday? No, I wish I had an elder sister, too.
She could be your older sister, too. If you want her to be.
Boom! That's a pickup line right there, man.
Boy.
Good morning, Sir Emil.
Good morning, too. Miggy doesn't seem to be with you.
Oh, Aunt Elsa suddenly called her. I think they're going somewhere.
Hey, Nars!
Oh, Pinang. I'll be leaving you guys. I'm just going to the farm, okay?
Take care,
Dad. Take care, sir.
Nars, have a seat. Over there. Let's talk. Let's make one thing clear. Really, now? You actually told on me to Phil?
I'm sorry, Pinang, that you got busted for being jealous. But honestly, you don't have anything to worry about because the truth is, here it goes, you're the only one who matters to him.
Fine. But next time, don't give me away, okay?
I promise, I won't do it again.
Okay.
Did you have vinegar with your food or is that you? It's a bit...
Yes, it's me. Actually, it's my legs and my feet, because I got bitten by ants among the haystacks after hiding from Phil. But then he still found me.
Oh, hide and seek among the haystacks. I like that. So what did he say when he saw you? Please give me a word-for-word account.
He told me earlier that I will stop courting you, but I never said I will stop loving you.
Why?
It's so itchy.
Huh? Why did you say that?
Because I got bitten by ants then. There were a lot of them. I had to run towards the well, and then my dad arrived.
Oh my gosh, such bad timing.
Who, my dad?
No, the ants. You know, I hope they don't show their little faces to me because I'm going to kill them all. They destroyed your sweet moment with Phil.
Phil!
Hey, Gab.
Hey, where are you going?
I just bought medicine in the pharmacy for Pina.
The letter. Have you given it to Pino?
I wasn't able to give it because Mr. Emil arrived. But soon, when I have a chance, I will give it to her.
Oh. You know, Phil, once Pino reads that letter, everything's going to be different.
What do you mean?
I mean, Pino might let you court her now. She might even say yes to you being her boyfriend.
Really?
So, Pinang, if those pesky ants weren't there earlier, what would you have said to Phil?
Honestly, my heart is really confused. Truth be told, I can't ask for anything more from Phil.
Mm.
Although, I did make a promise to my parents. I can't bear to let them down, Nars.
But Pinang, isn't that unfair to you and Phil as well? I mean, if you both hold back your feelings for each other, why don't you speak with Sir Emil and tell him that you should just ignore all the rumors around you? I mean, really, that's not even important.
Wait a minute.
Who's that?
Hello? Yes, this is Filipina Crisostomo. Yes, ma'am. I'll be there by 2 p.m. tomorrow.
Oh
yes, ma'am. Thank you. St.
Oh,
Mark's
oh
Hospital!
My gosh! Oh my
finally accepted. Orientation is tomorrow. I'm going to work.
I hope Megan and I get into
I hope
oh,
so, too,
pressure.
So that we can all be together.
Well, it's a bit hard to be hired when all you could answer in the interview was yes or no.
Oh, come on. That's not the only basis for recruitment. You have good grades and you got a high score on the board exams.
Oh, let's not forget my pleasing personality and my stage presence. I should really be hired.
Your phone is ringing.
It's ringing, too. Is this the same number?
Yes, that's the number.
Shh. I have to sound serious. Yes, hello? Oh, this is Narciso Malvar, yes. Yes, I am. Oh! Yes, okay, yes, bye!
This is it. What about Miggy? Was she accepted too? Ask her now.
Hello, Miggy. Has anyone called you?
No, yeah.
It's been 30 minutes already. Maybe just wait a bit more.
Miguel, maybe they're, still calling a few people and then they'll eventually call you.
Tell us already, okay?
There's a text? Okay, read it now. Tell us about it straight away.
Hurry,
read
it
up right now.
I'll tell you about it later.
Dear Miss Miguela Suleiman, we regret to inform you that your application as nurse to St. Mark's Hospital is currently stored for any relevant positions that may come up in the future. We appreciate your interest in our hospital. Thank you.
Oh, no. Oh, she also texted me. Wait. Hi, guys. Congratulations to you two. Go and take that job at St. Mark's Hospital, huh? I'll find the right hospital for me eventually, so don't worry about me. Anyway, I'm so proud of you. I love you.
Oh, I'm sure Miguel is depressed right now.
What do we do?
Pinang? Knock, knock.
Phil. What is it?
Pinang. I got you this.
I'm okay. I already put vinegar. It's effective. Thank you.
Just use this. It's better.
Thank you.
And this one. This is for you. It's my letter for you.
What's that for?
You'll find out. Okay, don't forget to use that on your feet, okay?
Okay.
I'll be quiet.
Hmm.
wonder what he wrote in this letter. He was being so mysterious earlier. I want to find out. Mom! Hello, Dad? I'm going to put these aside first, okay. So I can help you later.
All right, thank you.
See you, Dad.
Love, what do you want?
Just water for now. I'm thirsty.
Oh, Mom, great. Dad. You're just in time.
Dad.
Dinner is ready.
Thank you, Julian.
Vino. Oh. What's up?
Before anything else, I have some good news. I was accepted at St. Mark's Hospital, and I'm reporting for orientation at 8 a.m.
Wow.
Yes, my shift starts tomorrow, 2 p.m. to 10 p.m.
Oh!
Good job!
That's great!
Good job, congratulations!
Congrats! Great!
Well, group hug?
Group hug, come on, what are we waiting for, Mom? Let's go, group hug! Come on, Mom, come here.
Yes!
Group hug!
Oh, Dad!
Dad!
Group hug, Dad! Dad, you don't seem happy.
I'm not.
Huh?
Huh?
Because I'm very happy there's nowhere else to place it. Congratulations. We're very proud of you. Let me hug you.
There we go. Binang, why didn't you tell me earlier? I could have cooked your favorite dish for dinner.
That's okay. I just wanted to tell everyone at the same time. It's more fun that way.
Well, I'm happy that you are slowly getting closer to achieving your dreams. And thank you for not letting us down. And not even once did you give your mother and me a headache. All you think about is our family's welfare. Thank you very much, Pino.
Oh, Dad.
Oh, can you see it?
See why?
The best nurse in the whole of San Isidro! There she is! Group hug!
Group hug!
Again, again, again.
Será que Pinang já leu a carta que eu dei para ela? O que será que ela está sentindo? Por que ela não deu notícia até agora?
Something's on your mind. Is it hidden in your smile? Be my lady.
Halos isang daan. Iyon ang bilang ng mga araw mula nang dumating ako dito sa San Isidro. Mula nang unang nag-cruise ang landas natin sa airport, doon pa lang, naramdaman ko na iba ka sa lahat ng mga ibang babaeng nakilala ko.
Whatever.
Akala ko ay iyon na ang huli, pero iyon pa lang pala ang umpisa. Nabumawi ako sa mali ko na gawa sa pamilya mo, na makilala ko kayong lahat, na nagbago ang buhay ko. Isang daan. Ganoon karaming bibe ang aking binili para sa'yo. Na sinoli mo, kaya ako na ang nag-alaga. Na hindi ko inisip kahit ayaw mo, ay paraan para kita laging masilayan. Isang daan. Piraso ng everlasting ang handa kong ibigay sa iyo kahit gaano katagal. Para lang mapangiti ka sa araw-araw. Kaya kahit isang daang beses akong masabihan ng tatay mo na wag, do not. Iingatan ang pagkakaibigan na meron tayo ngayon. Kasi baka sakali sa paghihintay ko, magkatotoo ang pangarap kong marinig sa iyo na payag ka na maging nag-iisang libe ko. Sa iyo, Phil.
Forget the past, it's time to mend your broken heart. No walls divide us now, so dry the tears in your eyes. Nothing can stop us now, I'll give you all I have. Be my...
Por favor, valga mi alma también.
Now what? This is so confusing. Why is your heart so persistent, Phil? And now my heart is also becoming persistent.
My love will last until forever.
Oh, good morning. Let me do that, Mom.
Oh, no, dear. No need. Your father and I woke up early. Remember I promised you that we'll do everything we can to help you ease your cooking chores, especially now that you're working in the hospital.
Thank you.
You also need to save your strength for your work later. Your shift starts at 2 in the afternoon. Am I right?
Yes, Dad.
What time do you go home?
My shift ends at 10 p.m.
I'll pick you up. It's hard to go home by that time. The streets are dangerous, especially for women.
But you'll be staying up late. I'll go home with Nars.
That's okay. I mean, I just want to make sure that you'll get home safe and sound.
Thank you, Dad.
Go get your breakfast now.
Yes, okay, Mom.
Pinong, it's a miracle I arrived earlier than her. Then again, it's still early. Where are you, Pinong? I'm already here in the orientation room.
Grandchild? Grandchild? Where are you? Please come back.
Ma'am, where are you going? Is anyone with you?
Good morning.
Good morning, ma'am.
Gemma, undress.
Present, ma'am. Ma'am, will you please go inside now so that the nurse assigned to you can change your clothes?
Where's my grandchild?
I don't know, ma'am. She might be buying something, but she'll probably be back soon. For now, I'm going to help you out. Please tell me if you need something. Let's go inside? Okay. Be careful, ma'am.
Adrian Arsenas.
Present, ma'am.
Narciso Malvar.
Present, ma'am.
Cell phones are not allowed while on duty.
Oh, I'm sorry, ma'am.
Filipina Crisostomo.
Ma'am, I'll just call a nurse, okay? Outside. I'll be back soon. Excuse me for a while.
Ma'am? About Filipina Crisostomo, I was able to talk to her. She's on her way. In fact, she's in a hurry to arrive here.
So where is she now?
If you want, I can call her now, so...
I just told you, remember? Cell phones are not allowed while on duty. Do you want me to repeat that?
Sorry, I'm sorry, ma'am.
Okay, thank you.
Excuse me?
Yes, ma'am.
Good morning. There's an elderly patient in room 104. She soiled herself and her clothes were wet. She might develop pneumonia.
Oh, thank you. I'll inform the nurse assigned to her right away. She just went to check up on the other patients.
Oh, aren't there other available nurses?
There's a critical patient in room 115.
Oh, is that so?
All right, then.
What now?
Anyway, it's only 7:55 in the morning and she must be here at exactly 8 a.m. If she doesn't arrive, well, that means, I am sorry, but she will lose her chance.
I hope that you don't mind if I look through your things. You see, you need to change your clothes right away. Okay, this is what we need. Let's change your clothes, ma'am.
All right, we have two absentees. Filipina Crisostomo and Jordan Mariano. Whoever doesn't arrive will be replaced with applicants in the waiting list.
Oh, let me do that. Thank you.
Okay.
I'm sorry for the trouble. Today's a very busy day.
That's okay. I'm going ahead. I'll be late for our orientation.
Orientation?
Mm-hmm.
With Nurse Malou?
Yes.
Oh no, make it fast because she's strict.
Oh, okay. Ma'am, I have to go now.
Thank you.
Get well soon, all right?
Thanks again.
Sure.
Oh, ma'am, where could your companion have gone? She just left you like that.
Ma'am? Ma'am, I'm here, ma'am. Filipina Crisostomo.
Miss Filipina Crisostomo, you have just lost your job.
Ma'am, I'm really sorry. It's just
You're late and you are disturbing our orientation.
Ma'am, I'm not really late.
I am saying that you may go right now.
Ma'am, please allow me to explain what happened. I'm not really late.
Tell me later. Take a seat, since you're already here.
Thank you.
But that doesn't mean that you've been rehired. First day on the job and you've managed to... What's wrong with kids these days? All right. Out of 120 applicants, you have been chosen. That just means we highly believe in your credibility as a nurse. You are the most qualified among the rest. This means that you should know how to adjust quickly. The hospital has high expectations of you. That's why you people have to learn everything we will teach you in the entirety of your stay here at St. Mark's. Otherwise, we'll replace you with other applicants. You see, there are so many nurses wanting to work and stay here at St. Mark's Hospital.
¿Por qué será que Alan no dio noticia ainda?
First and foremost, be true to yourself. If there's something you don't understand or something that you're not sure of, then ask. The lives of our patients depend on that. Second, be true to your profession. That only means always be prepared. You must always stay focused. Any form of distraction is not allowed while on duty, and that includes accepting visitors, the use of cell phones, unless of course it's an emergency or if it's the doctors themselves who are texting you. Said this, and I've been saying this since this morning, that cell phones are not allowed. Whose phone is that?
Ma'am, I'm sorry. I'll turn my phone off now.
You see, Miss Crisostomo, because you were late, you didn't hear what I said this morning. Cell phones are off limits while on duty. But you should know that already. That's SOP. During seminars or conventions, what do? You turn off your cell phones, right? But since you were in a hurry to get to the hospital because you were late, you did not think of the things you could and could not do. That's why it's very important that you must all be here on time. Understand? So we won't be rattled. Is that clear?
Yes, ma'am.
All right. Miss Crisostomo.
Yes, ma'am.
I highly doubt that I will hire you again, even after I hear your explanation.
Lady Luck's so sweet.
What did she say?
She told me congratulations for making it to the tryouts. Then she said I could clinch the next tryouts. And that, I'm so great. That's sweet, right?
Is that sweet? Weird is more like it.
Hmm?
Huh?
But why?
Isn't it obvious? She's like a stalker, Miss Myra. She knows about your whole life, even what you're doing. Don't you think that she's weird, Julian?
Not really. See, if she wants to admire me, I respect that.
But why hasn't she introduced herself?
Oh, that. I do want to get to know her, though, so that we can become friends.
Who knows? Maybe soon. Sometimes when you develop feelings for someone and it's real, it's harder to express them.
Why?
Probably because she's a girl. And we know it's not really normal for girls to tell their feelings to guys, right? And sometimes you think that you don't suit each other, or you fear rejection.
You know, my mom told me that when it comes to love, everyone's on equal footing.
Miss Myra, tell me, you're not Lady Luck, are you?
Of course not. I told you that before.
Margaret, I haven't told you this yet, but I just want to thank you. You're always present during tryouts and training to support me. You're actually a big factor as to why I was able to pass the tryouts. And also, thanks for the concern when I got sick. I appreciate it.
You know, Julian, don't be too cheesy. Just treat me to your sister's caramel custard.
Sure, no problem.
Hey, me too.
No, I don't want to. Just kidding. I'll bring you one, too.
This is making me tense. Nurse Malu is really something. She's very strict.
Yes, that's true. It's my first day on the job, and I think I'm already fired. I just hope that she accepts my explanation.
Why were you late in the first place? Where did you go?
The thing is, earlier I helped an elderly patient. I saw that she soiled herself and there was no available nurse, so I helped change her clothes. That's what happened.
So it was a call of duty. The problem was that you weren't given a chance to explain earlier.
That's okay. You know what, Nars? A while back, I felt really happy. It feels so nice when you're able to help a patient out.
But who texted you earlier, huh?
It was Phil. He was asking how I was doing.
You know, Phil's timing, it's also off. Even if his intentions were noble, but did this love letter reach your heart at the perfect time, huh?
Really? You just
sent
a love letter?
Ah! Oh my gosh, you really are so sweet!
Oh, you know what, Phil?
Not a lot of guys do that now. Were you aware of that?
Yes, and I even asked Gab a favor to translate it in Filipino. To make it more...
To make it more heartwarming, huh?
Heartwarming?
Yes! It's direct to the heart. You can really feel it like that.
So, what did you write Pinang then?
That I love her so much. Very, very much. And that I'm willing to wait and will do everything to win her heart.
And even if Mr. Emil tells me, do not.
Many times... I won't give up.
To tell you honestly, it's really nice to know that his feelings for me run that deep. But it's much harder for me now, knowing that I still can't accept his love. And that's why, whatever feelings I have right now, I just have to set them aside. I need to focus so that we can be regularized in this job.
Yes, I agree. You know, I really understand you, Pinang. But you need to calm down, okay? For now, we have to stay focused on our duty, because you know that Nurse Malu, she's so strict. We cannot afford to commit mistakes.
Yes, you're right, so we'd better go.
Oh, by the way, Pinang, if it's not too much of a bother to you, can I read it? Can I read Phil's letter? Come on, please.
Wait a minute. The letter, I think I left it underneath my pillow. Mom and Dad might see it and come to the wrong conclusion about us.
So, what now?
But, Rose, why is there no reaction from her yet? I mean, I texted her, but, she hasn't replied. I don't think she, read my letter at all. What do you think?
No, Phil, you just learn how to wait, okay?
Just wait!
Yes, man. Girls naturally play hard to get.
We just process things better because, ooh, you know, you really? Men could be so, but that is dalos.
Pakipot? Pagdalos dalos?
Yes, you see, I don't know their English translation. Just search for them online, okay?
It's okay.
Dude, you just give me your ghostwriter's number so I can use it, perhaps, on my wife.
That's a good idea.
No, that came from my heart.
Aww, Bill! Pinang is really a lucky girl.
No, Rose. I'm the one who's lucky to have Pinang.
Hello?
Pinang.
Hello, Mom.
Hey, how was your first day?
It didn't really go that well, Mom. I was late for the orientation, so I got scolded.
But...
I'll tell you all about it later. Mom, where are you now?
Oh, I'm here at
home. I'm in your room changing your bed sheets.
Oh, Mom, please don't change them. Let me do that.
No, I'll
do it. I'll be doing the laundry anyway. I might as well
get started on it.
No, Mom, I want to wash them myself.
It's all right. I'll do the laundry.
Are working on so many things. For one, duty at the hospital is so hard. It's okay.
But Mom, I can do this.
Let me handle
the laundry and the changing of your bed sheets. Is that clear, Pinang?
And you just focus on the things that you need to do, all right?
All right, fine, Mom.
Okay, bye.
All right then, goodbye. I really hope that my mom doesn't see the letter. Let's go.
Okay, thank you. You can go back to your station now.
Yes, ma'am.
All right.
Ma'am.
Hi, Miss Crisostomo. Excuse me. I just received the report from the charity ward. There's an elderly patient who's looking for you there.
Is there a problem?
The doctor wants to thank you and brought you some food. So now I understand why you are late. That's good. But that doesn't mean that you'll lose your demerits because of your tardiness. That's why next time, the right thing to do is to come earlier. Do you understand?
Yes, ma'am.
And because of the help that you have given to that elderly patient, I'm hiring you again. Welcome to St. Mark's, Miss Crisostomo.
Thank you, ma'am.
Now, will you please hold on to this? Come with me. I want you to do something.
Oh, it's only our first day on the job, but you already look haggard. This is really stressful, girl. You know, I'm getting worried. I have a feeling that this will affect my beauty.
The truth is, Nars, I'm more worried about Phil's letter. Mom and Dad might have read it already. Goodness, I hope not.
Pina, listen to me. If they're meant to read it, then they will read the letter. Just like what happened to you earlier when you were suddenly fired. Then you were rehired within the same day, you know? If that happens, it's no longer within your control.
Okay.
Oh, don't let your father pick you up anymore. Let's just take a tricycle. Then I'll just take you home. Oh, but wait. Let's take a selfie of our first day.
What's this, a remembrance?
Mm-hmm. First day. Okay, one more.
Mom, I'm home.
Mom.
Why are you still awake?
Well, I was waiting for you.
I'm just doing some advanced reading so I won't fail anymore.
There you go. You're afraid to drop out of football, huh?
Oh, wait. Are you hungry? I'm gonna heat the food for
you. Oh, no, never mind. Thank you. Nars and I already ate. And next time, please don't wait up for me anymore. You're going to lose sleep.
Oh, my. How can we not wait for you? When you told us this morning that you were fired, and then this afternoon you told us you were rehired?
Well, you see, Mom, I was late because I helped a patient out this morning, and that's why I got fired. But then I got rehired immediately because what I did reached our chief nurse, and that's why it seems difficult, but it's fulfilling. It's a new feeling.
But you know, it's actually good. Remember what I told you? When you do a good deed, you'll not get something bad in return. So,
Very good, Pinang. Keep it up, okay?
Okay.
Always do good deeds.
Yes, Mom.
You think you can keep it up?
Hey.
Of course. You know that I can handle anything, no matter how difficult.
Even if it's painful?
I'll just change my clothes. Excuse me.
What?
You? Ouch.
Mom changed my bed sheets. Huh? But Mom was acting normal earlier, though.
I knew it! Pinang got in! Maybe I should call her to congratulate her. But she hasn't replied to me the whole day. Maybe she doesn't want me to call her.
Called?
Hey, Nars.
I just saw your Instagram post.
That's why.
I just wanted to call you to say congratulations!
Aw, thank you, Phil.
How come Miggy's not with you? What happened?
Oh, she didn't get in, but she's on a waiting list. So please just pray and hope for the best.
I see.
How was your day at work?
It was okay, fulfilling.
But tiring because the 2 p.m. to 10 p.m. shift is a very busy
time at the hospital we're working at.
That's why when we got home, we were both tired.
Dead tired.
It's no wonder Pinang has not replied to me yet.
Maybe she's busy?
She's dead tired?
No, not maybe, Phil. Definitely dead tired.
That's too bad, my poor Bibe.
Oh? What did you just say, huh? Your Bibe Pinang?
Maybe she's still resting, right?
That's why I think I should call her
to check on her tomorrow, so that I won't disturb her.
That's a good idea, Phil.
Also, I
should go and rest right now, because I'm also tired, Phil. But
thanks for calling.
Rest well. Good night. Congratulations.
Thanks, Phil. You too. Bye. You know, Phil's timing was also off, even if his intentions were noble. But did this love letter reach your heart at the perfect time, huh?
Dear Phil,